Reserve time.
Bounty hunter.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I'm doing good, thank you very much. You're still a little bit loud there, Sander. Yeah, I'm loving this matchup today.
I just saw that I accidentally put off my mic still on Hitbox, so I'm sorry about that, guys. We'll just redo the intro real fast. Welcome to the show match organized by Esports Against Addictions. And man, they're here for a good cause. They give education to children about, you know, addiction and those kind of things on schools and on other places. And a good way for them, they think, is to go and use esports and advise everybody against that. And so that's why we're here with this great match between Power Rangers and Burden Knight. It's a great best of three. And with me is Zach. You heard him a little bit. I'm sorry that I forgot to put my...
Yeah, I'm loving the matchup today. It's Power Rangers versus Burn United. I am personally a Power Rangers fanboy. I love how they play. They're a really good squad to spectate. And I know that there's a lot of chemistry between them. And Burn United as well, very strong team recently. Well, they are very individually talented players, but Sing Sing has recently left their roster and they've had a bit of a reshuffle here. And here we see Io and Bounty Hunter picked up on the side of Burn United. Personally, Io, I don't think he's top tier anymore. He's not first banned, but here he's been first picked. I don't think Wisp is that much of a high priority anymore. Just heroes like Winter Wyvern are pretty good against Io because you have that Splinter's Blast, so you can slow them both. And heroes like Witch Doctor and other heroes like that are really viable as supports and just really good counters for Wisps in general as well. That's why I don't think Wisp is that good anymore. I'm liking the Spirit Breaker pick from... Power Rangers here, they can just charge around the map, they can find that Wisp, and the person tethered to Wisp as well. So yeah, really good global presence coming from PR.
Indeed, they're already really showing up that they're here to play against this Io. This first picking Io indeed has been a real bit, well, iffy with all the new heroes with the Winter Wyvern there and just being so strong against him with the Winter's Curse. So yeah, yeah. He's just not there anymore. And Burden, they seem to have some kind of an idea of what they want to do. But Power Rangers, on the other hand, they're just not really bending against it. They're leaving up, like, the biggest, well, combinations for Burden. They can pick up a Tiny now, they can pick up a Bristleback, or anything that actually want PA. Only thing that's bent a little bit, that in combination, is the Gyro and Storm Spirit, just in regard of the ganking and the global presence.
Yeah, I think that PR... Winter Wyvern and Spirit Breaker can deal really well with strong melee cores, which Wisp usually partners up with. Like, Winter Wyvern just destroys... Well, you can manipulate the melee carry's damage into its own team. I think PR are confident that they could take on a Tiny, a CK, quite easily. What do you think?
Yeah, pretty sure. That's why they don't ban it out. They're here to play, and they're just not scared of it at all.
No.
And, yeah, for Burden, they pick up a Darkseer, so they do get some mobility to himself and to the odds due to the Surge. As well as the Falcon Welcome, bro, it's just always nice to have. And, well, the Bounty Hunter, it should be able to actually, you know, set up the kills. That's what they use this Bounty Hunter for. Get the global presence, have him sneaking through jungle, maybe on the lanes, check out if there's nobody else, and then relocate in with the Io and go for the kills.
Yeah, with this Darkseer pickup, I think this is a bit of a pub strat going on here. We have the Darkseer Iron Shell. When the Bounty Hunter uses Shadow Walk as well, that's very potent, especially against heroes like Winter Wyvern. Winter Wyvern's not very mobile at all. And Bounty Hunter, after being Surge, and with that Iron Shell, just the physical damage from the Janata hit, as well as the Iron Shell, is very strong against these weak int supports.
Disruptor. Indeed, and
they're gonna Disruptor's good.
Disruptor, yeah, man. They're just picking against the Io right now. Like, if you go in with Io now, you will be just sent back and your carry will be all alone.
Oh, and he'd be trapped in a little electric pen, won't he? That's unfortunate as well, like a trapped animal.
Indeed. It's really, really sad if you want to, if you play against a disruptor as an IO. It's just so annoying. And even if you don't get Glimpse back, you can just be awaited by a static storm plus kinetic field. And what are you gonna do then?
Exactly, you die. Darkseer can't really surge your way, bounty hunter won't be able to go invisible, and that relocate would just be silenced. So Disruptor's really good against this team, and the Glimpse as well shouldn't be underrated against Darkseer. You search your way, you pull right back. And Naga Siren, hey? Dire team
pick. Yeah. This is gonna be a core Naga. It might just be. That might then be the combo for Io. That's something that you actually almost never see in competitive Dota, this combination of the two of them. It is good to have though. You can reset the fight quite easily after somebody, if they use a static storm and the Winter's Curse. Just wait for it to go off, reset and go in again.
Anti-Mage, we're going to see a ditch or our Anti-Mage. The Naga Siren, I think, is really good setup here for the Darkseer if they time it perfectly. If they don't get it just right, the whole team fight could be whiffed completely. And Disruptor's really good against Naga Siren as well, because after everything's been set up, Disruptor can put down that kinetic, the static storm, and just disrupt the whole of Burn United's strat.
5 seconds remaining. Indeed.
And I think the Ensnare's pretty good against Anti-Mage as well.
Yeah, it keeps him locked down away from blinking.
Wait, can't he blink out of it?
No, he can't. It prevents blinking.
Ah, I see.
So you're just stuck to the ground there and you're not able to do anything.
Yeah, that's quite unfortunate. Yeah, Anti-Mage, Ditch RR plays a lot of Anti-Mage. Like, a lot of Anti-Mage. He's probably one of the, in my opinion, one of the best Anti-Mage players in the world. He's just so smart, and just his map awareness as well as his farming awareness as well. He spots out creep waves. He balances jungling and fighting, and his item build is really, he adapts to the game. I think it's really good.
Yeah, the one thing that I actually do want to mention here as well is actually that with the Darkseer, farming for Anti-Mage will become a little bit annoying. Having the iron shells on the creep doing you constant damage means that you either have to pick up a fast Ring of Health, maybe an extra set of tangos, and it will cost you more consumables.
Yeah. Yeah.
It will hurt you in the beginning a lot.
Yeah, Ditchara picks up the two sets of tangos at the start, I'm pretty sure. Like, that's one of his builds on the Anti-Mage. I am a PR fanboy, sorry everybody, sorry. Okay, and last pick on Burn United, they need a mid here. Storm Spirit's gone out the pool. I would have said Storm Spirit right now.
Storm is out, Shadow Fiend is out.
Queen of Pain.
Yeah. Leshwork, they've taken out the...
A lot of mids right now.
Yeah,
I think
both sides
Magnus,
mids.
A Magnus could be very good for Burn.
Yeah,
you need to keep that Anti-Mage on lock.
They don't have a Ryze here, though, so that's...
Yeah, there's a few stand-ins right now for Burn. And there's one for Power Rangers as well. Jackal is standing in for Sunlight, sorry.
Moonlight and Sunlight,
he's
the one and the same person.
No, Moon used to play for Power Rangers quite a while back.
Okay. I didn't know that.
Nah.
Well, you're the fanboy here, so.
Maybe
I'm just going to root for Burden.
No, maybe not a Drown. They don't have enough range heroes, but the Silencer could be good. Invoker mid? But not so good against the Anti-Mage.
No, you don't want to pick that first Anti-Mage. As well as that, you have then a really weak laner in mid, which means that Spirit Breaker can just go on you all the time. As well as you're open for ganking from Winter Wyvern from the... From the Asian, so they need a strong mid laner, maybe even a Viper or something. And what are they going for here?
That's a dual lane mid.
Yeah, with Naga, Io, I guess, then Darkseer solo, Bounty Hunter solo, and Enchantress in the jungle?
That's what they're going to do. Bounty Hunter's not a bad core. We usually see Bounty Hunter as a roaming support or just a support on the lane, guaranteeing farm for the carry.
Mm-hmm.
I think that Bounty Hunter is going to be utilized right now just for that track goal. Get that Naga Siren up and running. Ooh, Zeus, sweet. We see a Zeus. Oh no, this is not a Ditch RR Anti-Mage. Ditch RR has been playing mid recently since Sunlight can't be, is not in the PR at the moment. But yeah, it's
so
a Jackal Anti-Mage.
A Dirty Ross Zeus. I don't think I've actually seen this one before.
Yeah, Ditch RR plays a little bit of mid as well as carry.
Oh, we're gonna see that. Okay, Gorok is gonna be playing Winter Wyvern. Okay, Jekyll. Yeah. I've never seen him play before, so I'm gonna be interested in seeing what he will do here.
Gorok, he's ex Hellraisers.
No, I mean Jekyll.
Oh, Jackal, yeah, I've seen him in a few games. He's look, see, put the 8 tangos, I knew it. So you want to introduce Burden?
I will take Burden away from you. For Burden, we have on the Radiant side, we have Big Num playing Darkseer on the middle. We're going to have Nihis playing his Io, very well known for that. Mind Control is going to be playing the Naga Siren. Miomi is going to be playing the Bounty Hunter. Enchantress is going to be played by Come With Me.
Okay, and on the side of the Power Rangers, we have Gorek rocking that Winter Wyvern. We have Spirit Breaker being played by Cheshire Cat. Jackal on the Anti-Mage. The magic will end here. PRJ4 on the Disruptor. And DTR-Ra rocking the Electric Dwarf.
He got the light. He got the Immortal here, man, out of the chest. You're I don't know if it was gifted or if he actually got it. Let's check real fast before.
It's non-tradable.
Non-tradable. It's not gifted. He actually got him himself, and he hasn't really used it, or at least not destroyed any barracks.
Yeah.
That's kind of hard to do as well with a Zeus. Oh, maybe some Deso Zeus in the pubs to get it going.
Yeah.
And we're going to have a little bit of a skirmish here on top. Oh, there's going to be the slow coming out of Mind Control. He just comes in here with the tether. Jack was taking a lot of damage, but Mind Control is taking more. And Dirty Bow, he is stuck between three. He might just be the first one to fall, as he will not. Miomi picking that one up, and they're looking for more. All these Iron Shells doing too much damage in the early game, and Gorek is going to take fall as well. Now they go after J4. He will have a Riptide soon. And the Iron Shell still going strong here. He's just going to eat through the tower. And is Mind Control going to follow this on the tower? No, he won't.
No, that's very bad. Well, it wasn't even a trade. It was just a bloodbath, really, on the top rune there. Who got the bot rune there?
Come With Me got it.
Yeah.
The trade was the bounty rune for Dirty Ra, but that's, like, in no way worth it.
No, not at all. And we just see the Wisp mid?
Yeah.
Wisp mid?
Yeah, that was because, you know, Mind Control was, following them around all the way through, the same as... That Come With Me is at the moment solo laning versus Cheshire Cat on the bot.
Yeah, I think that Cheshire Cat likes this matchup right now. I don't think he's going to be hitting Come With Me in the face, especially with that untouchable and the low attack speed on Cheshire Cat. But I think they're just going to trade last hits right now, maybe not much harass either.
Oh, Mind Control taking some damage here. He's slowed up by the Arctic Burn, but. Maomi is there and he's just laying the damage into Gorek. It will end up with a lot of poking and damage done to both sides. But it seems like Mind Control is going to be playing a support Naga with Big Num as a core Darkseer.
DTR-Ra taking a lot of damage off the Io here.
They're really just fighting all over the map at the moment. And
yeah, it's brutal right now.
He gets fairly low here. He has his bottle coming on the courier. Yes, he has. They're going to go for the room. Maybe Mind Control will go mid now, but he will have a serious disadvantage versus Dirty Wah, who's already level 3 here. I'm not completely sure what they're going for at the moment with this draft on Burden. Like, this is like a pub thing here. Miomi with the with the Iron Shell following down the supports here.
Yeah, I did say it's quite a potent strat here. Oh, and here we go, there's a go on J4.
He's taking a lot of damage. Jackal comes in here to fight as well and they take down my homie. While Jackal's taking a lot of damage, he has just 60 HP left. 40, yeah, he can blink out in one second. Tango, he's able to survive.
He tangoed up. He's got that cheeky little tango there. He lives.
So a 1-0 trader, well, actually in the middle, it's a 1-1 across the board. He's just able to pick up Dirty Ra here in mid. Yes, solo kill for him here.
Wait, what?
Yeah, Nihis got a kill on Dirty Raya. Yes, he did.
Alright, guys, you know what to do in your pub games now. Just Wisp mid.
It's just a really strong hero. There's a really strong attack animation as well as actually the orbs do a lot of damage. And he's gonna go onto Momi here and he's gonna get the full orbs off of here onto Dirty Raya. He's really low. He's actually gonna die here. There's another kill here and Momi is able to pick this one up.
Uh oh.
So far, it's going great for Burden.
Yeah, this Wisp, 202, 3 minutes in. Well, luckily for PR, that Wisp does drop off as a carry, so.
Yeah, I'm not completely sure what it will end up doing with Nihis here. I think it will just be a saving Iowa, kind of, and just trying to make space later on for someone else to farm it up, but. Who's that gonna be? Because Mind Control at the moment, he seems to be playing as a position 4 or 5 even. Mm. And Neon is just seeming like the number 1 here, like the position 1, so...
Yeah, I think PR have a very solid draft, and it's around the meta. Burden United, I don't know what the hell they're doing.
Well, they're gonna go for Dirty Raw again, and he's just gonna die here. Those orbs, man, so strong here. Oh, Cheshire Cat comes in. He's level 5, but yeah, he knows that he can't fight up versus the two heroes here. And he will back off.
This is... pub strats. It's working.
Yeah, they're at the moment it's working, but they will have to do something. And I'm really wondering what they will do to push down the towers to gain map control and to make sure that the Jackal doesn't get too much farm here.
Okay, we have Cheshire Cat charging on the bot lane onto Come With Me. Oh no, maybe not.
Oh no, on top Bignum, he actually gets glimpsed back into the kinetic field here. He's gonna die right now to the Winter Wyvern. There's gonna be Knees, he comes in. This is gonna be a cleanup maybe. There is still a blink on Jackal. He gets out for now, but is it gonna be long enough? No, it's not. Knees dominating.
A dominating Wisp at 5 minutes in.
4-0-3. Oh, he has 100% kill participation? What? Crazy!
Yeah.
Oh, he's showing why he's such a strong IO player, honestly.
He just knows his limits, that's all.
Yeah, he just goes incorrectly with the ganks here, and PR is not expecting this, and so far they've been really caught with their pants down.
Oh, yeah.
But Nias, is he gonna go back in mid again? He has his orbs. Yeah, he will. He will try to look for something again. Maomi is here. The CJ4. Oh! Just out of ward range here. If they can just go for J4 right now, if they want to. There you go. They're gonna go in. J4 taking a lot of damage. Glimpse is there, but he uses on Maomi, so that doesn't really matter that much. Able to get the kill here with the Shuriken toss.
This is this 4 deaths now on DHRR. And he's realized he's just relegated to the jungle. He cannot do anything else right now.
Oh, he has to try and do something here in the jungle. He's gonna go and bottle crow a bit now. Maybe, yeah, he stacked it up here and... Still,
yeah,
the problem is
out.
He can't just leave the mid lane alone because... Dezo, Io, maybe of Maelstrom or something like that, it will hurt a lot. And they don't really have the highest armored targets apart from the Antimage here. And they're actually gonna go on him. Knees comes back here, there's gonna be the net on Jackal. He can blink fairly soon. Is he able to get out? Oh, the vacuum is there! He's gonna be stuck there. He actually already used his blink. What? He went in aggressive there?
Yeah, he went into the hard camp. The hard camp was pulled across by the Radiant side. And yeah, he blinked in aggressively and got the Seder kill.
And there was a trade-off there. Seder for his life. And Gorek, he just TP's out. Nope. But it won't work. There's going to be the Shuriken toss. There comes Nias in again and he just picks it up. Unstoppable streak.
Oh,
keeping
my.
His 100% kill participation going here. While in the bot lane, Come With Me is left alone and picks up his... 6 minutes, 7 minutes,
they found the electric dwarf in the jungle. Oh no. But
Dirty Wise Fight. Oh! Are they gonna come in here with the relocate? No, they're not. They're just gonna walk in here. Nias, he's looking for something. Maybe steal the stack or just walk out. Seems like he's going to
steal the stack.
Oh man, this is.
Oh. Is this really happening? Are we actually seeing this?
Yeah, and honestly, he can just go on bot. Okay, he actually can't go on bot because it's a disruptor. He will glimpse him back. I was just thinking, he can just go on him.
Yeah.
But, that's just going to be a little bit too dangerous and probably unsuccessful.
I'm not too sure, right? What would you go on a core Wisp? Dagon E-Blade?
No. You're actually going to go damage items. He has an incredibly strong attack animation. So you can actually build it like that. And with him being strength, he will become fairly tanky. Well, yeah, Cheshire Cat, that's not what he wants to do. And he realizes it.
Usually when the Spirit Breaker charges a Wisp, it's usually a...
A dead
not
wisp.
Too good for the Wisp, yeah. Yeah. I've never seen a big angry cow just run away from a white ball of swamp gas before.
No, God. This is... They're going hard.
This is getting to the point where it's non-consensual. It's getting worse for PR right now. And how do they come back from this? Smoke ganks? Use the Spirit Breaker to gank around the map? Maybe wait for the six... on the supports as well.
They just have to make space for Jackal. Yeah. Bignum was a little bit too fast there on the trigger. Mind Control wasn't close enough just yet to get the net off.
The problem was space for Jackal. There's three heroes on the top lane for the Radiant. Burden United is spending all their time here.
And they're going in middle. They're going to go on Naomi. Nias comes in, but he will be too late to help out his buddy. And I don't think they're able to pick up any kills here. But yeah, it's actually going to be an armlet on the on the IO here.
That's quite good, actually. Yeah, I could understand the armlet.
Ooh, mind control. Yeah, he will take a fall here. He is all alone. There's going to be the Nether Strike on top of him, and Jekyll is able to pick up a kill. But now, in the meantime, in bot here, Dirty Ra, he's able to TP out. No stuns to stop this, and not enough damage either. That one orb that missed, what's the difference?
Yeah. And now Jekyll gets a bit of me time up here on the top lane. He's just farming with some creeps, and he's got that level 6 eventually. Jekyll's really been like cut out of this game. Burn United have prioritized a lot on this anti-mage, and it's paid off. And yeah, Anti-Mage only has 35 last hits.
Yeah, versus Nihi is 41 at the moment. 52 on Big Num here. And 57 on Comb with Me with the Midas.
Oh,
there's going to be the glimpse on Mind Control. He's taking a lot of damage. He gets a net off on Dirty Ra. They just need a little bit more damage here. Are they able to deal it? No, TP comes in from Comb with Me as well. And they're able to save him here. Using even the heal from from Enchantress to get him up. Oh, he wants to get a net up, but he's fairly low here. Dirty Ra does have Turning God's Wrath of cooldown now. He just needs one Lightning Bolt. And he is able to kill off Mind Control.
Yeah, this is reminding me of my pub games. There's four people who just go mid, and like when the like Wisp. How is Wisp so farmed?
He's just getting kills everywhere, and even then, it's a good hero to less hit with. It's, as I said, it's just such a strong attack animation as well.
Yeah. Oh my god.
They do need to level 6 on bounty though. They could even earn more money with Trackle then. That said, the game has stalled down a little bit, and PR trying to get the upper hand again. And Big Num, oh, he tries to TP out, but it was way too early, and he's going to take a fall here. He does use the mechanism, but he will get finished up with the Mana Void from Jekyll.
That's a really early mechanism, but he doesn't have the boots, though. Probably one of the main reasons.
What? Did he die there?
No, he bought the mech.
Oh, yeah.
And he didn't prioritize the boots. No. Maybe more levels in the Surge might have helped him out a bit there.
It doesn't matter, there was way too much damage anyway. As well as too much control.
Mm. And, J4 just got his 6 on the bot lane now, so maybe he would be able to do some things. Gorek as well, he's just getting some levels in the mid, but it's just not coming to the PR supports.
And Jekyll, he TP's out, he sees everybody here, and he just goes bot to farm there. They might just concede this top tier 1.
Well, there is a Glyph of Fortification if they do want to TP up there and get some sort of response.
They do have TPs on... Well, actually, everybody that's needed. The only problem is the tier 1 is already down and there's no space or way to defend this. Bomb with Me is going to take this one. Here we go. He is going to build up versus for an Aghanim really fast. Or it might be a Bloodstone.
I think the Aghanims would be better. It gives Enchantress that bit of tank, and just the extra damage from Impetus is OP.
Let's see, does Burden want to defend this bottom tier 1 tower? There is a song if they need it. No, just Riptide Jekyll a bit. Get him off. Oh, they might want to jump on him here though. He's gonna get Glimpse Bat, he's gonna get charged, he's gonna die before any rotations can come in. Now he's just come with me here alone, he's gonna feed away his kill, his life. That's a free kill for Dirty Ra.
Yeah, and meanwhile on the top lane, there's Big Num skipping the creep wave right now. They're trying to get as much damage as possible onto this tier 2. And some TP reactions coming back from the PR right now.
Yeah, there is a long charge on Nihi from Spiritbreaker. They're looking to go after him, but Gorek, well, yeah, you can't walk like that. Cheshire Cat, he's gonna get orbed here a little bit. Nihi's team is in their neighborhood. Oh, they find Naomi on the backlines. Winter's Curse is going to be popped on Mihis, but there's not really any damage to be done on him. Well, Naomi, he was going to get killed off by the Splinter Blast here. And how good it went for Burden United in the beginning. It's kind of going bad now. They're just giving up kills and not getting anything back.
Yeah, looking at the gold graph, there's a massive dip right now for Burden United. They've just gained... Well, PR just gained about 2,000 gold from that last engagement. Come with Me feeding himself away at the bot lane. Maybe it was just a distraction.
Cheshire Cat, he tries to TP out, but they just do a quick song and they will keep him. He's gonna charge away from this though. And he's gonna survive here, and Maomi is not close enough. He will need to hide a little bit here. Oh, Maomi, did he see him? Yeah, he's pinging him out. He knows that he's somewhere close here, and he doesn't have the mana. He still gets found. It was a nice play to make, but yeah, it just wasn't enough.
That's unfortunate for Cheshire Cat. And wicked sick on the IO. Still 100% kill participation.
This he has show, finished off everywhere. His armlet here as well, actually.
Oh, I don't know how they're going to bring down this Wisp. I don't think anyone's ever said that while casting. I don't think they can bring him down yet.
If they really combo up everything, they are able to kill him. But it's going to be so hard, man. This pick just completely caught them off guard. And they're using it in such an unconventional way that's really working out.
Yeah, Jackal's about 500 gold away now from that Battle Fury. After you see the Battle Fury, do you think he's going to farm a bit more and then take some fights? Or is he just going to jump straight into the fights, get a Vlad
after the
Fear straight up?
He's going to farm. They're just going to farm him. They don't want to have him fighting anytime soon. As long as they can just drag out the fights and don't have him there. That's the best way to go at it right now. And oh, Maomi, he was found. He gets glimpsed back into a sentry as well as a kinetic field. He's stuck there. His team is there to help him out, but it's just not on time at the moment. Oh, Nihis. As well as Big Number still there. Big Number's getting charged here, but they want to get Nihis. That's the big kill here.
Lock two. And 1 second left.
Yeah, and he just gets back straight to the same place. And he dies. Big Number was there. He tried to help him out, but it just didn't work in any way. And they give Spearbreaker a wicked six streak and 602 gold. This was a swing of 2.1k and 1800 experience. Well, come with me. That's the next person on the list here to kill. J4 is ready. TPs are coming in. This is too late for come with me to get out of here. There's gonna be the glimpse. The charge.
No.
Jekyll comes in. He's taking a lot of damage. Even popped the static storm on top of him. They're following him down. They're attacking really, really slow. It looks like a slow motion video. But he is gonna die.
Yeah, and he goes down now. And oh, Ditcher in the mid lane, he's getting poked by right now by the mind control Naga Siren, and that's it for Ditcher. Good night. And Cheshire Cat cancels the charge. Oh, and there's a deny on the bot lane, anti-mage.
Net in middle though. Cheshire Cat taking a lot of damage and he's gonna die here. Bounty at the picking up the kill.
Space Cow goes down there.
Yeah, there was a track kill as well. But yeah, they did get the tier 1 here on bot. Did Jekyll get the last hit on it as well? No, they didn't get... Oh, they denied the tower. The tower was already done. My bad.
Yeah. I think that the track mechanic in this game is really strong at the moment. Like, Bounty Hunter can bring back a game. And also, the track gold can really help the supports on the side of Burn United get a lot of farm. Like, Naga Siren, I have no doubt that Mind Control could go into those carry items.
He's going to go for Radiance now. He's 1400 gold. He is saving it up.
Yeah, the mischance could be very good against the anti-mage as well as just the...
That was a little bit too fast. Can he get off the song in time? Yes, he can. He is still alive here. He does get charged. They're looking for a reinitiation here. Bignum pops down the wall. Where is there going to be the vacuum? Yes, that's going to be there. But there is actually the Winter's Curse. They're all stuck together there. Cheshire Cat is cleaning up house. Nihis is going low, but there is going to be the armlet toggle keeping him alive for now. They're just falling right now, actually, in burden. And as well as on the side of PR, come with me. He is low, he's gonna get charged. Bignum is gonna get hit in the way. Jekyll might just go for Bignum. Here, while come with me is gonna get killed by Cheshire Cat. There is gonna be the hit. Charge back on Bignum. Yeah, he's gonna get found here as well. Kinetic field is there. Vacuum.
And that's it.
That's not enough.
4-2 for PR, and they were on the back foot. Like, what happened there was, it was that Winter's Curse from Gorek. That was perfect. He got it just off, just in time.
Yeah, they just stood together after this song, and it was actually quite pretty much a downfall there.
That was a very chaotic fight, but Burn United have really good execution there. Just I think the communication between PR was much better, and just the execution as well.
Yeah, and now PR, they are back on top again. After being behind the entire match, now they're ahead in XP by 3k. And the gold is gonna near, or at least reach the equilibrium point right now.
Yeah, it's definitely turned around a lot right now for PR.
And Jekyll, he has his Yasha now as well. Let's just take a quick look at the net worth. I kind of forgot to put it up there for now, since there were so many fights and they're going strong all the time. Net worth right now, Jekyll, 9.4k gold. He is over, he's almost 2k ahead of Come With Me, who is building up for his Aghanims here. He just needs 50 more gold and he will have it. After that, we have Cheshire Cat on the Spirit Break. He's building up for a BKB right now. At knees. He has his armlet. We'll see what he builds up next. He might just go for a Desolator or for something else. Maybe a Maelstrom. We'll see what he goes for. Well, Jekyll, ooh, he's just able to blink out in time before Nias can get the orbs on him.
Okay, looking at the ward coverage right now. We got some wards coming out from PR just right down the middle. Okay, maybe
another time because they're going strong here on the bot lane. Glimpse is there on Come With Me. He's stuck here. He's going to get the healing off, but yeah, they don't want to go in him right now. And they will leave them a little bit. Oh, but now the Odora comes in. And it's the backline. Cheshire Cat, he's going after Nihis. There's going to be the Static Storm Kinetic Field. The combination keeps in Nihis as well as Bignum. And there's the Winter's Curse keeping them stuck there as well. Jekyll taking a lot of damage from Come With Me from the Impetus Strikes here. He's able to dislodge them. Well, they're going to go after J4 and Gorek here. Bignum is still going there. J4, he's getting low. He will actually not survive here. But they do kill off Bignum. Come With Me is still here in Miami as well. But they have to leave fairly soon. It's a 4
Three
versus
for one.
2. Jekyll comes in.
Oh, man, avoid.
He kills off Come With Me.
Yeah, there's a big, massive mana void there from Jekyll. Just
Maomi, he's gonna get found. He's gonna get charged. They have a sentry.
Oh, they have sentries on Gorek.
They also have a dust on Cheshire Cat. There's no way that Maomi can get out of this. He's gonna get slowed by the Arctic Burn. Jekyll doing a lot of damage. And actually, Gorek is the one to pick this up.
And that was a 5-1, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, a 5-1 indeed. Oh, yeah. Of course, the 5 recap won't show it. It will just show the last kill here.
Yeah, there was a J4 died at the start. Well, just after he got off his abilities, he died. So I was thinking, on your Wisp, what do you pick up next? A BKB?
It's a possibility. Maybe Sanjay Yasha even. You tank up, you get more movement speed. Get more damage as well from it with the strength on there. You get the bomb chance. There's a possibility there, but yeah, the BKB would also be a good choice versus all the magical damage coming out of PR.
Yeah, definitely looking at the graphs right now, it's definitely going in favor of Power Rangers.
Yeah, the XP has been for some while now, but now the gold is also now starting to dip into their favor. And they're
gonna
go for Come With Me. No?
Yeah, we have
a charge. What's he going for? He's charging the creep. Okay, well, Come With Me. Oh! Almost there with the stun from the Centaur creep there, but not close enough. Bignum, he's actually found here. There's going to be the Vacuum on top of them. He's trying to turn this one around. He gets glimpsed back a little bit. Nihis comes in there as well, but Bignum is still taking a lot of damage. But he pops a Mechanism and he gets healed for a lot due to the Io Tether here. Now, Io, he gets Winter's Curse. He gets blown up.
Denied!
Oh, actually denied here by Darkseer. Okay, he used one of the illusions to kill him off there. That's a big play. And they're still going. They're going to go after Bignum, after Gorek here with Bignum. While Come With Me is actually trying to clean this one up in the back lines. He got 2 kills. They're going to go after Gorek here. He still has his Glimmer Cape here.
Yeah, he knows that Vacuum's up, so he...
He's trying to dodge this one around. Is he going to get hit by the Vacuum? No, he's not. He can TP out now safely. And
well
he will.
Played.
Big play there from Gorek.
Yeah.
But PR definitely overstaying their visit there.
Yeah, that's essentially just a 2-0. Wisp got denied. And their Wisp didn't lose much gold anyway. Yeah, what really happened there was Disruptor got caught off guard, Vacuum straight up there, and the DigiRR was just stuck in that wall. Like, the Vacuum was perfect from Bignum. And he was just stuck, he couldn't do anything. And with the net from the Naga Siren as well, it was just chaotic.
It definitely was. And how is Mind Control going? Is he is going for the Radiance. He has 3100 gold towards the Sacred Relic now. Just needs 7 more and then he will have it. The classic support Naga that we've been seeing more and more these days.
Especially in the C region as well, I'm pretty sure Naga's picked up a lot there.
Has he?
Yeah.
No, not at all. Not at all.
Not at all?
No, I've been casting the entire week MSI Dragon Battle and I haven't seen one Naga.
Oh,
maybe one, but...
Maybe one, yeah.
Yeah, Miracle picked him once, I believe, but yeah.
Okay, we have a charge on the top lane.
Nice.
This Wisp's in trouble.
Is he gonna relocate out of this? He's gonna get blown up just before he can do anything. That was just a big bowl of anthems there, just being destroyed anthems. And Jackal, he's gonna go after Comb with me. He's taking a lot of damage here. He's gonna get charged. Manavore doing, oh man, so much. Bucknum is there though, he's keeping him alive, but there's gonna be the Thunder God's Wrath killing him still off there. The Cheshire Cat, he's looking for Mayomi right now. He gets off the 18% bash here.
Illusion.
And yeah, he's able to charge away. Mayomi's gonna just be left here. While on the bot lane, they're going after the tier 2 tower of Burden United. It's not the best pushing line of this. They're good at, you know, creep clearing, but destroying the tower is another thing.
I agree with you there.
But at least Mind Control has pretty much his sacred relic now. He just needs to get the courier to the secret store. As we might just be in for a really long game here. With an anti-mage and a Naga Siren. I don't know, who do you think will actually will be the favorites in a late game situation? If you have a farm Naga versus an anti-mage?
Oh.
As well with just the entire team composition behind it as well.
I think that Burden United have the stronger late game if all of their cores are 6 slotted. But Power Rangers as well, I think it could be even, but just a 6 slotted Naga is just so potent, especially against an anti-mage as well. It's debatable, really. It just goes down onto execution and individual player skill.
Smoke of Fum, come with me. What is he looking for? Is he going to go after Cheshire Cat there? Or no, he's going to go for a wrap around here in the middle. He's alone, and he is going to get spotted with the Thunder's God Wrath here. They know something was up. Well, Jekyll, he's just split pushing here. He's going to go for the top tier 2. They don't have a fortification. They will just lose this tower.
He's going to be Naga.
Okay. Yeah, he's just using this. Okay, the tower will survive here. Will he go back in again? Cheshire Cat is charging all over the map. They might just see him here in the middle. They're getting in more people. Yeah, they don't want to give this up. Okay, they're going to rotate in 2 people already just to defend this. And actually, at the moment, it's just Big Num because Come With Me went back to the base.
Yeah. Well, PR have most of their big team for ultimates.
Big Num. Oh, Winter's Curse on top of him. Charge is also going to come in. There you go. There it is. He's going to die to the mana fort of Jekyll. And now they say, okay, we still want this tower, but they don't have the creeps. Okay, now they will arrive. And Blink, aggressive forward from Jekyll. He just thinks, you know, we will be able to do it with this. They saw Come With Me as well as Nia's coming in from the back.
4.5k gold now on Jekyll. What do you buy? It's got to be a Heart to Rask. Maybe a BKB, Skull Bashers also potentially.
I think it's going to either be a Heart or a Skull Basher.
I think he could really afford getting a Skull Basher, just how far ahead he is right now, and maybe get some more kills and work towards that Heart to Rask. And PR are taking a lot of towers right now, so I think he should purchase the Basher.
We'll see what he goes for in the end. I would favor actually the Heart of the Rush just to build up more for late game. As well as just being incredibly tanky to survive through the combo. But we'll see what he does soon. Oh, he's actually found here. Come With Me and Knees walk past him. They poke him a bit and Jekyll just blinks out there. Some mutual respect there and not wanting to fight each other.
Ah, see, Dota is a game where everybody loves each other. I don't know why they all fight all the time.
They should just have like a nice tea party here.
Yeah, the Dota tea party right in the mid lane.
Like a little bit of a high tea going on.
Oh, of course, yeah.
You would like that. You're from the UK, so.
Oh, it wouldn't be as interesting to cast it all, but. Yeah.
Definitely not sitting in the middle sipping tea.
Eating biscuits. And we have a smoke here from Burn United. They're going towards the Rosh Pit, I think. I think they believe that PR's taken Roshan and all Cheshire Cat by the Ancients.
He gets found, he's gonna get charged up. He has his BKB fairly soon. Oh, those impetus are gonna hurt a lot. He gets vacuum back and he is dead.
Yeah, Ditch RR full staffed him and then the impetus hit Cheshire Cat in the back.
That's a death courier. At least there was nothing on it.
Yeah.
But these impetuses are just dealing so much damage.
Dagger and Septim on Come With Me. It's nothing, you know, to underestimate. And
indeed.
They're just gonna walk into Rosh Pit.
Yeah, they do get scouted out, but They don't seem to care too much and they just start laying in the damage. Is PR able to defend this? It's 4 versus 4 at the moment because Combat Me is in the mid lane. Oh, Naomi. He sees J4. He's dealing in some damage versus him. He's able to walk out before Jekyll's able to kill him off there. Rush comes out of his den here while they take over one of the illusions of Jekyll here.
Yeah, Rush is on half health right now, so...
And
I think...
Mind Control, he has his Radiance now.
Yeah, it's not too late on a... Support Naga.
Well, it's 29 minutes. It's okay. There's nothing wrong with it.
No. But it just enables this Naga Siren just to pick up more farm and just get fatter and fatter and fatter. And just transition into that position 4 role, maybe that position 1 role as well.
Yeah. Eventually, he will take over everybody.
Oh, yeah.
But we're a long ways off from there. Well, we're just going to have a charge in on knees. He's going to get found. Static Storm, Kinetic Field on top of him. He gets blown up. Cheshire Cat is looking at Big Gnome now. Oh, man, his mana just gets instantly drained here. Mana Forge is there. They kill him off. Now Mind Control is Winter next Skirt. On the list. Winter Skirt on top of him, keeping him in place. And he will die as well. Dominating streak. As well as a godlike streak for PR right now. Naomi, he's the next one here. He's going to get dusted up and killed as well. Triple kill for Jekyll.
Godlike. Beyond godlike. Jekyll there. Showing off his new anti-mage, which I haven't seen before.
Butterfly was his item of choice.
Yeah,
as well.
Come with me, just TP'd right out. He's like, I'm having none of that. He just... And here we go now. We're going to see the Aegis on Jekyll, and maybe we'll see an high ground push right now, or maybe just get those tier 2s on the mid and the bot lane.
Yeah, they're just going to get map control first. There's no reason for them to push straight up in now. The only reason if they will do it is if they get a good team fight going. Otherwise, they will just go for tier 2s.
Yeah, that's probably the best bet.
It's the safe play to do. They still have some time before the Naga gets anywhere near scary. At the moment, it's just the Radiance. It's annoying, but you're able to deal with it.
Mm. And now we're looking at the net worth. Ditcher, Archer, Shikat, they're definitely climbing up the net worth now. Jekyll is way out ahead. Just come with me in the second spot. It's definitely PR have brought this back. Well played by them indeed.
Come with me. Oh, Jekyll sees them. They see each other. Jekyll just casually stealing away one of the Asian creep here. Static Storm, Kinetic Field. Come with me. He is stuck. He's taking a lot of damage and he's going to die here. Knees is not able to save him there. There's going to be Thunder's got Wrath. Naomi is found. Knees. He gets back into the fray, but that's not the fray he wants to be glimpsed into. He dies as well. And a double kill again. For Jekyll, he's just finding kills left, right, and center.
And he's got a load of last hits as well. He's got 300 last hits. He's double the average.
And he has also 13 kills.
Yeah. And Jekyll's played really well this game. He was shut down immensely. Just putting that aggro tri-lane top with the constant iron shell harassment as well as the bounty hunter harassment as well. Jekyll has played outstandingly this game.
Indeed. And Dirty Ra, he has his Octarine Core ready as well. Get some lifesteal, get some reduced cooldowns there. And just, you know, be able to spam it out more.
1.3 second cooldown on Arc Lightning.
Yeah, that's nasty.
That's
a lot of DPS if you can just keep on casting that. Though his attack animation, attack damage is a little bit left to be desired. But of course we have Jekyll here, he's just one going away at this tower here. There's going to be the net on top of him. He's taking a lot of damage here, but he still has the Aegis. So even if he dies, what do they really care? They're just putting in a lot of damage. He's going to go invis here, though. Oh, Naomi taking some damage. Come with me. Oh, Jekyll, though. Almost dies from those impetus there. Pure damage. Not something to laugh at all. And Cheshire Cat, he's a little bit stuck here. Oh, he just pops his BKB. Come with me. They might want to reset this fight here, but they can't. Winter's Curse is there. They're all stuck. Can they even get off the song here in time? No, they won't. He will die as well. Big Gnome gets off a good vacuum wall combination here, getting the Aegis off. But this is just the Aegis so far. And they already have 3 down. Big Gnome, he's going to get changed down. He's going to get found underneath his own tier 3 here. And Cheshire Cat, he is not done. He's going to get a kill. Double kill for him.
That was savage by Cheshire Cat. As well as Jekyll with that perfect mana void. Ditchara just spamming that Arc Lightning. What did Burden United do? They melt. They couldn't do nothing against that. And that Winter's Curse from Gorek, and here we see GG.
It is over. This is the game already. First game in this show match organized by Electronic Sports against Addiction. It's a great cause, guys. Make sure to check out their website as well and help them out in any way possible. And yeah, this was the first match of our best of 3 here between Power Rangers and Burden United. Power Rangers taking this one. We are the casters from Swiss DC. I'm Sander. With me is Zach. We're going to go into the break now, and I hope to see you all again for the second match.